welcome to the United States, and congratulations on your new deal with Roadrunner Records.
Thank you.
So why don't we start from there, from the moment, let's say, to you find out that you're part of this huge metal family now,
yeah,
to, you know, till today.
How we got there?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, we released our first album in 2010. That was in the recordings, and I think it was through the end first, and then a prosthetic in the US.
Yeah, it took a while before it came, was released in the States. So yeah, it was out in Europe and Norway and Scandinavia for almost a year, I think, before it was released.
Yeah, it didn't really get a proper release in the US, I think. So, yeah, it'll be good to finally do it right this time. It's, yeah, but we've still been, we've done three US tours, and that's kind of where Roadrunner showed up in the picture. Like, we first met them when we played at South by Southwest last year. And then, you know, we've seen them at some shows, like when we played New York with Skeleton Witch last year. And yeah, they just seemed to really want to put out the album, and yeah, so we went for it.
And let's talk about the album. Obviously, we have the album cover here.
Yeah.
For those who are not familiar with it, it's called Meir. So why don't we talk about the, you know, the concept of this album?
The concept is, it's not really a concept. It's on the first album, like the lyrics dealt mostly with like Norse mythology and Norwegian folklore, I guess, but I just made a point of staying away from it this time. It's everything from, you know, performing rituals and tree panning to drilling a hole in your head to, you know, like more spacey kind of stuff, like Antichrist coming from a black hole down to the earth, and yeah, it's all the good stuff. Like musically, it's we didn't like really have a master plan. We, yeah, we just made 11 songs, and that's the ones that are on the album. It's, yeah.
It feels like a natural progress from the first record. And personally, I think it sounds better, and it's, yeah.
Yeah, I think we kind of expanded our sound a little bit, and
yeah,
in the end, this album
it's,
felt
it's
like,
more of a rock record than the first one, I would say. Yeah.
Yeah, we're happy with it.
What is the meaning behind the name of the band?
The meaning?
Yes.
It means Stranglehold. It's just a Norwegian punk kind of name, so, yeah.
So you guys grew up with a lot of punk rock in your headphones when you were growing up?
Yeah, there was a lot of bands with names like that in our hometown, so that's where I kind of guess where it came from.
There's a lot of like Norwegian punk bands with like Norwegian names to the lyrics and their band names.
Yeah, just the like pretty brutal names, I guess. It's, yeah, can make a small list, but then I have to translate everything. So.
Yeah. And they should know, right? Or they can Google it themselves.
Yeah,
yeah,
they can.
And what's coming up for you guys? Obviously, right now you're doing a huge promotional run in order to push the record correctly, and I would imagine there's going to be some shows coming up in order to really get the word out.
Definitely. Yeah, the album's going to get released March 26th, and yeah, first we're doing a European tour that's going to be like almost 6 weeks. And
yeah, it's long, long. We start in the UK and then do all of Europe, do Scandinavia, and then I think that we have just a couple of days off.
Yeah,
no,
a few days.
We can't announce that yet.
Yeah, but
we'll be back. We'll be in the States pretty short after the release.
Yeah, people just have to check our website, like our Facebook page or roadrunnerrecords.com, and yeah, I think we'll post some American dates pretty soon.
And do you guys get to play in your hometown in this European run?
Yeah, we'll do a couple of shows in Norway too. So that's gonna be fun.
And why don't we talk about, obviously, Norway has always been very important in the overall music spectrum, especially with heavy music. How did that influence you guys growing up, especially?
Like for me, I've been a huge fan of black metal, so yeah. So I guess I've kind of been inspired, like, you know, to start screaming, and like I started screaming in a barn when I was a teenager, like 16, 17 years old, and that's kind of where I started to sing. And then,
yeah, he was a cowboy.
Yeah, I was a Norwegian cowboy. What about you?
You should tell more about that. That's a funny story.
Yeah, it's not too much to tell. It's just that I was milking cows, and that's just where I, you know, could, you know, I can, like, it's just easier to scream with only cows around than people around you. Or, you know, my parents would probably yell at me if I did it in my bedroom, you know.
So you were listening to black metal while milking the cows?
Yeah, it's, I actually just got a Norwegian radio station that was just bad music on there. It's, yeah, I didn't really have like an iPod or anything at the time, so.
Yeah.
But from what I understand, in Scandinavia, heavy music is a lot more quote-unquote popular than in other parts of the country. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, like Norway's, or, you know, Scandinavia definitely is really into rock and metal, like,
Yeah, they play it on daytime radio, which I understand it on.
We're a mainstream band in Norway. Like our first album, it was on the top 40 album sales list for over half a year.
Right, yeah.
And we won 2 Norwegian Grammys for it. It's pretty crazy. I never expected that, really.
But I think that's very cool because, I mean, I think it makes it a little easier to kind of get out there for, you know, up-and-coming, especially metal bands, because what other bands face around the world is, like, kind of metal is really kind of shoved aside. Well, and, you know, in Norway, you just said it, it's kind of like, it's out there. There's, like, you won Grammys over there for that.
Yeah, I don't think you really can do better than what you're able to do at home, you know?
Yeah, it's a great starting point for the rest of the world, too. If you can do good in your home country, it's easier to, like, go out in Europe and the States and tour.
Yeah.
And what was the day or the gig that you kind of looked at each other and you said, okay, we're doing, you know, something?
Yeah, that was actually like a year before we released our album, and we got booked to play Roskilde Festival. I don't know if you know about it.
Yeah,
we played like the warm-up stage before the actual festival starts. And there was like 3,000 people chanting our name, and that's like, gave me the goosebumps. Yeah. And we, like when we got on stage, I think we just had so much adrenaline, we played all the songs like twice as fast as they were supposed to, but it was still a great show though.
Any other moments that stand out?
The first time we played Oslo at Rockefeller, and it was sold out. That was definitely like a big moment.
Yeah, it's like 1,500 capacity, so that was like one of our first big shows in Norway. And you know, we've done like crazy stuff, like warm up for Foo Fighters in Norway, and like 22,000 people.
There's so many. Yeah, there's been so many cool stuff happening. It's hard to like pick one.
Yeah.
And from your new songs, or your newer songs from, you know, from Meir, which songs stand out, especially when you're playing them live?
We played a few of them live, so definitely in our new single, Bruane Brenn, I think it's really fun to play live, and I think it's going to be really cool to play it now after it's been out, and people have a chance to hear it, because it's like a good sing-along part, and
it's a very catchy chorus.
Yeah. So that's gonna be cool. And
I think there's so many songs on this new record that are gonna be like live favorites. I can't wait to like get a new set list together with all the new songs.
Yeah, especially the last song on the album, just called "KVELERTAK," is just basically a shameless band anthem, just like a big rock song.
Yeah,
with a pretty big chorus. So I think that's the plan is to close our sets with that song. So
and start with a new, like the first song on this new record, it's like an intro song, which I love it. It's gonna be great to like start set lists off with that song.
Right, to get them adrenalized
going.
Yeah, it's definitely, you know, with playing live in mind, we made this album, so yeah.
And you mentioned Bruane Brenn, you have a brand new video pretty much came out a couple of days ago, and there's kids playing you guys pretty much, right?
Yeah.
It's a bit of Vidar's idea, basically, you talk about it.
We've just had this idea, it would be cool to use kids in the video. We didn't really know what they were gonna do, but we wanted to have kids.
You talked about having kids drunk driving and
That was in the we were thinking about that in the beginning. And we pitched the idea for this director, his name is Stian Christiansen, who is from our hometown.
It's like a Norwegian movie director.
So. Yeah, but he's worked a lot with kids before. So he and the producers kind of took the idea and made a story out of it. And they just contacted like music teachers in our hometown and asked them if they had any young kids who were really good at playing and rocking out. So a bunch of kids just sent in like videos of themselves playing to our music, and they picked up 6 young guys. And they were just amazing. I came to see the filming like the day before to meet the kids and like show them the songs, but they already knew. They knew the songs, and they were just rocking out, so it wasn't really much for me to do.
Definitely recognize some of the moves from the kids.
No, that's cool, especially because, as you know, music videos maybe don't have the same power that kind of they used to have, but that gives the bands more flexibility to be more creative, so you don't have to be on the video anymore. It's kind of like, something different.
Yeah, it's it's not a must for us to be in the video. We'll probably do one that's later at some point where, you know, the band is in the video, I guess, but we just haven't had time so far. Just been super busy.
And as far as, you know, the next record, because I'm sure you already have some new songs jotted down or written down, when is that going to start happening? Do you have any sort of schedule for some new music? I know you're going to be busy, but...
You mean after the new album? I don't know, it's I don't think we're going to be in a rush to make the next album, but I guess we'll definitely, like, this new one was made in a pretty short time span, and that was like the biggest concern, was trying to make time to to actually write the music. So I'm just gonna imagine that we're gonna try to spread it out more, and
we'll probably go when we have if we have time off between tours to go back. People have song ideas. I don't know. We haven't really thought about that.
Right. So you guys don't really write as you go. You just kind of when it's time to go into that process, that's when you start writing.
Yeah, that's how this one came about. Uh-huh. At least is pretty much like most of the album was made in 2 months.
Pretty much.
Last summer. So yeah, it turned out good. So yeah, once we got started, it went pretty smoothly, I think.
And what are your expectations coming up? New records coming out. What is, let's say, your initial goals as a band?
We don't really think about goals. We'll just, try to tour as much as possible and do the live shows as best as we can, and we'll let the label deal with the album, and that's their worry now.
Yeah, definitely all the touring part. I like do more American tours now that we have an American label too. We're going to Asia, and I haven't been there before. Oh well, we played Singapore. But I think we're going to Japan and stuff like that. I'm really looking forward to that.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of new places, and it's shaping up to be a great year and a really busy one.
Yeah.
Is there anywhere specific that you're maybe like you have never played that other bands, friends of yours have told you about that you kind of really want to get there?
For me, it's Japan.
Yeah.
I'm actually born there too,
but
I don't remember anything. So that's the country I'm mostly looking forward to playing in. So, yeah.
Yeah, me too.
Also?
Yeah.
Okay, any final words for the fans watching right now?
Buy the album, come to shows, give us your money.
People with the merch, right? Definitely.
Yeah. No, I didn't mean that.
Cut.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.